Goya! Now, for those who weren't in the shir 2 days ago, they're trying to guess when my birthday was. I wouldn't tell them. So they came yesterday and they said, it's not my birthday. But you missed it! It made me look bad. Anyway, oh, the shir started. Good morning, Rabboisai! Ah! Good! Lili Nishma Simi Morosi Ruspas Mordechai. Good morning, Rabboisai! Ah! Lili Nishma Simi Morosi Ruspas Mordechai Luschus! Akiva Simcha Ben Fega. What's up, Mendo? Attached are the pictures of Seo made of Rosh Hashanah in the Marshal's Beis HaKnesses in Ostrov, Ukraine. Mayor Springer. Really enjoy your share. Started the night, I heard the meaningful people. Here he is, Siyom. This guy says, from Miami to Tampa, honestly, I don't even recognize myself. Perry, I'm not sure if he means that he doesn't recognize himself literally or he doesn't recognize the fact that he's learning Torah on a plane. That's probably what he means. Here's my first birthday present today. Boy Bayoim present. Happy birthday. Got my friend Jerry Isaac to join. From Uncle Phil. Yishkoyach, Uncle Phil. This is Mo Landy again. I love these things because you could use this device to watch a game, to watch a show. But here's a chevra of people getting together to learn Torah. It's unbelievable. So we'll start with a controversial email here. It's controversial because I know I'm going to get a lot of haris on it. I'm not advocating this. I'll explain a little bit. Hi, Rebellion. I'm Avrich learning in Koilo, Baruch Hashem, here in New York. His name is Y from New York. I don't know if I have his... Okay. He says his parents offered him a position in the family company, which belongs to my father. It's a successful business, Baruch Hashem, which would earn me half of the business's earnings and a handsome salary. Although I'm happy learning Torah, this offer became very tempting to me as dreaming of making a nice salary this year and possibly making it big in the upcoming years was staring me in the face. However, I came across the Art School interview you had recently when I saw you spoke about the way you're making a lot of money, so unimportant. Mati, you're coming up. Where's Mati? He's busy with the cake. Here, it's coming up here. The kits are a long thing. When I gained this inspiration, I started listening to Stefanski classics, and then came the clincher. I came across Shabbos Daf 115, life's almost over, invest for the future, when you said to the questionnaire, it's not important anymore, Mati, it's just not important, which was the reference to money, sent a chill up my spine, and I realized that Hashem was sending me a clear message to continue steiging. Not only is it a clincher for me to stay in learning, it was a clincher for me to join MDY family from Masechtas Tainus. I want to thank you for all you do, Klai Yisrael. Regards, Y from New York. So, just to address this for a second, I'm not advocating that people should learn all day and leave their jobs all day. It's an individual thing, each individual. What I do advocate is that you should spend more time learning Torah. No matter what, if you're working 10 hours a day, stop that. Work 8 hours and learn two, etc., etc. Shalom Aleichem, how are you? So, and each person individually, if that's what works for you, it works for me. I learn all day now. I like it. I love it. Yesterday I was at a Shiva call and a guy almost got out of his chair and attacked me. Almost. He's like, the Haredim, they're not Jewish anymore. So each person, it brings up a lot of emotions. That's why I said it's very, it's controversial. But, okay. Which one do I read now after that? Oh. You know, Jonathan Iskowitz. You showed a picture the other day of a group of people in Flatbush scene making the first scene ever. Myself was Sean, and one of those people was Rafal the barber. And he brought, you remember I said something about the child, that girl, which he also made a scene. Since then, he's been learning with his son every night. Earlier today, he called me and said, you have to come over here right now. I have someone in the chair who wants to sign up to the DAF. I ran over and signed up a new member, Yehuda Niazov. Right afterwards, Rafal turned to the next guy waiting for a haircut, Shlomi Sperber, and signed him up too. Shouldn't get a haircut there. It's a dangerous place. Rafal asked me to make a poster to sign people up and going to hang up in his store. Below is a picture of Rafal with Yehuda and Niazov in the barber's chair. Oy vey. I didn't print it up. It came out by mistake. I didn't realize it's a picture. Okay, here it is. I don't know if you could zoom in. Let's see. Let's see you zoom in more and more. More. Oh, not bad. Wow. Mazeh? I don't know what that is. Okay. I open up before Shir. And also, wait a minute. If you stay there, stop there. Wait. Zoom. Go back to the Zoom for a second. Here is Rafal the barber with his children. If you remember the picture. Okay, right over here. Yeah. Okay. Vosnach. Ooh, it's late. So, with that being said, I just want to say about this barber, and we're going to talk about the program next week, but what I think we should do is, and it was successful, people took literally a box of Art School Gemaras to give out to the friends. So in the barber's case, you could sign up on growmdy.com, I think it is, and click there instead of just one Gemara, you click, I want a box, and if you're ra'ui for a box, maza. Okay, whatever. Oh, this Toronto Sium. I got to look at this later. Okay, I don't want to waste everybody's time. Shkoyach. Oh, this is a birthday present?
Yeah, it's a birthday present.
How do you know?
From Toronto.
You brought it from Toronto. Mazze. Oh, I will say this here. I don't know what this is. Oh, another one? Hey, Shkoyach. Wow. I have to blow it? There, you blow it. Here, come, y'all, come here. This is my Yoel, my 11-year-old. So yesterday I came into the house, and there was the Mati and whatever, the guys brought balloons. And my cleaning lady says, oh, I didn't know you're 64. The night was upside down. Okay. Shkoyach. I don't know what this is. Oh, there's a bunch of birthday cards from different people. Everybody says, so today, there was a Siyum in Brooklyn, the Hatzolah guys, the Chevra. There's a present in there. I shouldn't throw it out. I won't throw it. I should open up now? So you come here. You brought it. You open it up here. This box? Oh, it's an MDY. It's hard to see, but if you look closely, there's an MDY. No, it's a Hanukkah thing. Very nice. Shkoyach. Birkas of Hanukkah. We'll have to give one. We need one for every guy in the Siyum. Beautiful. Real quickly, so they called me from there, from during the Siyum, and I picked up the phone. There's a guy that does stuff at the shir. He has my phone number. And they started playing Rebbe. Click. Shut it off. I'm not going to play that game, the Rebbe game. But one thing, yeah, Yosef, one thing, yeah, you could do is there's a guy in shul that sings for years already. Every time I walk in the shul, he goes, Elelele. So our voice it together for my birthday. They don't know how to do it. Oh yeah, okay, fine. Ooh, that felt good. Even though I was the only one singing it, it felt good. Yeah. Okay. A bracha, the birthday bracha. The bracha is that everybody should be able to be miskasher HaKadosh Baruch Hu on a higher level than they are right now, whatever that is. Through Torah, Avodah, Gmilus Chasadim, etc. I do have to say some of these sponsors, and they're gone. And there are a lot of them today. Hold on. We're going to learn a little bit today. There is a lot to learn. Oh, here. Whew. Here we go. Sefer Tainis is dedicated by the Kessler and Davis families, Refuah Shleimah from Miriam Esther Bas Dvoira. Paras HaChodesh, Yoili, Lili Nishmas, his father, sister, and Shver. Paras HaChodesh, Reuven Klein, for his mother, Nechama Bas Kolev. By the Hannes brothers, in honor of the Hannes Zebedia and Chris Penn, Benazera families, and Shlomo Nazari for inspiring us to join MDY on the occasion of Rebelli's birthday. May Rebelli be Zoch, the King's Spirit, turn until 120. Amen. And may Rabbi Yosef, Rabbi Gershon, Rabbi Yeshua, and everyone else in MDY, can you do what they're doing to help Rebelli succeed in doing so, Mastech, and everything that comes your way? Aliza and Avi Sherman. Dedicated in honor of Doiv Ber Lachman, wishing him gezunt, parnosa, nachas, b'chol tuv for at least seven more dafyomi cycles from Lachman, Teichman, and Salman families. Joe Berry, in memory of Yisrael, Ben Yosef, Yoni and Ella Gershon, in honor of the 8th yahrzeit of the Finkelsberger Rebbe, Zeichel Tag Lebrocha, Rebbeinu Shmuel, Ben Rebbe Yitzchok Elimelech, Chaim, in honor of Rebbe Eli's birthday, May Hashem bench you, the Knesset give you shir with Gizum Nachzen Harchavas Hadas by Sholem Kushner. You're coming up. You're going to say your name loud. In honor of my best roommate and friend, Bensi Friedman, Mazel Tov, and his son's bar mitzvah, which I'm not there. I'm supposed to be there. He's my partner. He came into every one of my, I should have been there, but I'm not because of you guys. Love, Sholem Kushner, and Nathaniel Gans. By Michael. Harbader. By Michael Harbader. In honor of the arrival of Isaac Zafir to Israel. I guess it's a payback from yesterday. Of Isaac Zafir to Israel for the Mir Yachi Kala. Peretz Chaim Levine. In memory of my namesake, Peretz Ben Hill Yaakov Sedowitz. Hes Vav Kislev. Grew up not far from Ponovich. Happy birthday, Reveli. Shkoyach. And by Donnie Finalist, there's a voice side. In honor of my son, Ozzy's engagement. Woo! Ozzy, get over here. Come, get over here quickly. It's crazy. Mazel tov. Shkoyach. Your dad is a great guy. Your brother's a great guy. But once you're up here, I have a big question. I was very late this year. As you can see, it was late. And I see him driving down the street. So I stop and say, could you give me a ride up? He goes, yes, no problem. I get into his car with my son. It took, 30 seconds. He drove, I'm not exaggerating, 2 feet. He says, okay, now you can get out. What happened?
There was no parking here.
But what were you thinking that you told me to get into your car? I don't want to embarrass you in front of everybody. There's nobody really watching. But is that a true story? 2 feet you drove, right? Left. You scored for the ride. I really appreciate it. Hakaras HaTov. Thanks. All right. Now we can start. Wow. Donnie, what a kid you brought up. Chesed. Chesed. Donnie's in charge of the fund. Gives out money to different guys in the shir and to the neighborhood. Unbelievable. Okay. Mamish like his father. Wow. Unbelievable. He thought he's coming up here for a Mazel Tov. Okay, Rabbis, we got to learn here. Where are we holding? So we said yesterday, we're talking about rain. And when do you start saying this bracha called tipa, v'tipa? When you're able to see the rain, remember that picture? One drop goes in, another drop comes towards it. Chasim v'kala, you hear, mamish. In yonad yoyma. Like the rain that says, I call tipa v'tipa, mishiyete chasim likras kala. Thank you. Or maybe don't rav. Fine. And then we had a machlokes of Rabbi Yochanan's Messiah, Ilu Pinul Moshir Kayom. And then he says, you finish off Baruch Rav Yadois. Now we're holding Omer Rav Papa. Rava says, you say Kela Yadois. And Rabbi Yochanan says, Rav Yadois. Last words on the daf, Omer Rav Papa, Hilkoch. Nimrinu Litarvayu Kela Yadois, Rav Yadois. That's why you should say both. You should say something like, Kale, Roy Vaidai, some people say Rashi. It's a little different. The point is you say both of these things. Now, Roy Vaidai doesn't mean most of the Shvachim that we say in the Kodesh Baruch Hu. Roy means a lot. It's not, he has 100 and we're going to give you 75% of it. It means we're giving you a lot of Vaidai. Roy Vaidai. And your Kale Vaidai. Omer Bavo. Godol Yaymak Shomim Mitchias HaMeisim. The day that it rains is greater and more important to us than Tchias HaMeisim. It's unbelievable stuff. How do you understand this stuff? Why? V'iluk Shamim Bey, didn't we do enough of this stuff? Oh, no. Ilu Tchias HaMeisim L'Tzadikim, V'iluk Shamim Bey L'Tzadikim, Bey L'Rashayim. Because Tchias HaMeisim is for only Tzadikim, and the rain is for everybody. So rain is more important. There's a maisa with the Rebbe Kivega. We shouldn't say any maises today because we don't have time. But we're starting off. So there was a guy that used to lend money beribis. So the Rebbe Kivega told the Chevra Kedisha sell the plot for 4 times the amount. So the family went to the authorities. He's not treating us right. So they called him Rebbe Kivega. Rebbe Kivega said, look, a typical plot goes from now until, lower the value in Gershon. It goes from now until Tchias HaMeisim. But this guy's not getting up. So his plot is forever. So it costs 4 times the amount. Weiter. Azoy Zakman. Uplingi the Rabbi Yosef. Domer Rabbi Yosef. Tech shi shkula k'tchias HaMeisim. Kavua b'tchias HaMeisim. Where do we say the bracha of Geshem? In Tchias HaMeisim, in the fourth bracha. So, but he says, shkula. It's not that Geshem is more than Tchias HaMeisim? It's equal, 50-50. They're both the same. Omer Rav Yehuda Gadol Yom HaGshomim Kiyom Shenitna by Torah. The day of rain is greater than Matan Torah. Greater than Matan Torah. The day that we all look at and say, wow, we're all Nevi'im that day. When it rains over here, one rain better than Matan Torah. Shenemar, Yarov Kamotar Likhi. Yarov is a lesson of drip. Likhi is what I teach you, my lekach. So, I'll drip my lekach, my Torah, like the rain. Ve'in lekach, ela Torah. So Torah is the sustenance of the neshama, and rain is for the guf. Shenema v'me'ein kemach ein Torah. You have to eat in order to learn Torah. Shenema ki lekach toiv nasati lachem. We, Nachman and I, we sing the song every Shabbos together in shul. So does the whole shul. But we have our own little harmony. We have like a little low harmony at the end. Maybe Nachman will do a little thing for you. I don't know. Ki lekach toiv. How's it go? What's the low harmony? All the way at the end, right before Kaddish.
It's the high part, then it ends off like that.
You want to do that? Everyone together. It's not a modern shushol, chas v'shol. We sing this song also. We could sing it. Kilegach tov nosati lochem tov yisi alta zoivu. Rava Omar. So Torah si alta. You see, lekach and Torah go together. Rava Omar. Yoisim yoyim shenitnu by Torah. It's greater than the day that. You saw the Marsha says. How could it be day that it rains greater than Torah? He says, yeah, because we're going to see in the Gemara soon that Torah can actually kill you. If you don't use Torah the right way, it's samamavis. Geshem gives sustenance to all of life, everything, to behemoths, to goyim, to rishayim. There's no distinction. It's my Torah should be like matar. In other words, matar is there's a mashal and a nimshal. What's the main thing here? Matar. The Torah should be like matar. So you see that matar, that rain, is more important than Torah. Havayimir kata nitla bagadol. Rava rami. Contradiction. Siv. Yariv kamata likhi. It should drip like rain. Uchsiv tizal katal imrosi. And on the other hand, it's like dew. Dew is much less. Which one is it? Is Torah like dew? Is it Torah like rain? In tamat chacham hagunu. If he's a proper tamat chacham katal. Then tal, as we learned, is all year round. It's very important. It's always good. Bimlav or feyu kamotar. One pshat. Mashal learns a little differently, but our feyu is a lashon of arif, as we're going to see soon. When there's a body between two cities and we don't know what to do, we take a egla, a calf, and we're arif the head, something like this. So it's a bad thing. Bimlav or feyu. If you're a tamut chacham who doesn't act properly, chop off his head. So we're not going to get into it 100%. There's a whole nefesh chayim, what a Torah lishma. Rashi says he learns Torah because HaKadosh Baruch Hu commanded us to learn Torah. He doesn't ask questions. Why do you come to Daf Yomi? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu commanded, and not so you should be called a Rebbe or Rosh Hashiva, etc. Now, Tosis asks a question. Well, we see in a second. Torah sinas l'isam ha'chaim. Shenemar, eitz chaim hi l'machzik. We don't have time for songs now. Eitz chaim hi l'machzik. And also, you're not in charge of songs. You're in charge of stats. Thank you. There's other people in charge of songs. Eitz chaim hi l'machzik in bava. Oimer rifus tihi l'shorecha. Huh?
And we did the song. Right?
That's why he's not in charge of songs. He doesn't chav exactly. The lows and the highs. Listen. There's a reason why it's different people are charged different things. Rivus te'il l'shorecha, it should be healing for like a kid in the womb gets sustenance from its mother. Voimer ki moitzi, when you find Torah, you find the daf motzei chayim, find life. You hear? I literally every email. Oh, I found. Now I found a reason to live. I found something in my life. It's unbelievable. Torah does it seriously. But if you learn Torah Shalai Lishma, now according to Rashi, it's problematic, right? Because Torah Shalai Lishma would mean, based on what Rashi said before, he learns it to be a Rebbe or something. So you should call him Rebbe. Oh, look at this guy, he knows all Torah. Chashuv. Nasli Sama Mavis. It could be some of us. Now, Tosis says, well, we learned that you should always learn Torah Shalai Lishma, because Mitoch Shalai Lishma, Ba Lishma, even if you don't have the proper reasons, you'll come to the proper. Tais says, Shalai Lishma over here means Likanter. If you're learning to shtuch somebody else out, to say, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, look at me, I know better. That's Shalai Lishma, that's Sama Mavis. Shenemar Yarev Kamato Likhi, literally, take off your head, you're doing the wrong thing with the Torah. Veinarifa El Hariga. By the Egla Rufa, as I showed you before, that's Hariga. Over here, we have Reb Zera. I'm pointing it out. This is the famous Reb Zera. Lacey, Mar, listening. Could Reb Zera tell us Dvar Torah? Omalei.
Reb Zera cut the head off the Rama.
Different story.
He wasn't
the whole
Rama, Reb Zera, right? Right,
but
Zera was
going to do it. Okay. I don't know if he cut him off. He killed
him.
Yeah.
He got his head cut off.
Lacey, my listening. Omalei cholash di boy velo yachilno. I'm weak. I can't give a Dvar Torah now. Lememar milsad agata. So say agata. That's what we're learning right now. Rabbi said this is lighter stuff. Even in the time of the Gemara, this is considered lighter. So say something in agata. Omalei hachim omar b'yochanan. I learned this from b'yochanan. Maidach siv. Ki yo'adam eitz asada. Person's like tree in the field. What does it mean? If you have a fruit bearing tree, you cannot chop it down. If it doesn't have fruit, you could. Okay, if he's a proper Talmud Chacham, you can learn Torah from him. You can't chop him down. He's a Talmud Chacham. I don't even want to say what it says here. Chanina, Barzel be Barzel Yochad. So you have this pasuk, but it's important to see the end of the pasuk. The end of the pasuk says Barzel Barzel Yochad Vish Yochad Pnei Reyeu. It's like this is like humans, just like metal to metal. What happens when you how do you make a sharp knife? Metal to metal. So two people Yachad when they work off each other, it sharpens them. My barz is echad mechadis chaveroi. One sharpens the other. Avshnei tamid chacham mechadis zeb alacha. When you learn chavrusa, something's going on with that picture. He knows. No, I'm just saying. Is that how they're singing on Zoom and everywhere else? It's the new style. It's like a DJ. Okay, tamid chacham mechadis zeb alacha. Amir rabbi mechana. Lama nimshul dimi tari keish. Shenemar halichos dvari keish numashim. Yeah, but you're spacing out there. But you know what? You're the only guy that didn't hear it. Let me repeat it for you. Just like the metal sharpens its one another. Like a DJ going back and we're saying the same thing again. And so too, the two Tamid Chachamim sharpen each other. They fight with each other until they come up with some clarkite. Why is Torah like fire? You need a couple pieces to get a fire going. When you learn on your own, I'm going to have a big problem with the sugya, because I personally learn 95% of the day by myself. I do have a chavruza for an hour and 15 minutes, Rabbi Yedidya, my Rebbe, but that's it. So it's pshat. It's not 95, the math is off. It's part of pshat, excuse me, whatever, 10%. Badim is a lashon of levad, by yourself. Vinuyalo, they'll be fools. Cherev al suneim shel tamid chachamim. Anytime the Gemara says suneim shel tamid, the haters of, it's referring to themselves. It's a lashon naki, lashon saginar. Cherev al suneim shel tamid chachamim. There'll be a sword on the tamid chachamim. Shoyskim bad bevad b'tayr, when they learn by themselves. Vilayoid el shemitapshim. It causes you to become dumb. Shenemar vinuyalo. Vilayoid el shachaitim. It's a sin. Yeah, Noyalnu is a lashon of chet. That song you can sing, David. You want to sing it? No. V'boy seimim alcha Noyalnu sorry tsoyan v'hisu es Mitzrayim. The bottom line is like this: can you learn by yourself? We see that Rabbi Yashiv learned by himself, the Chazon Ish, the list goes on and on and on and on. I saw Rabbi Chaim Kanevsky learning by himself a lot. So how do you learn by yourself? So first of all, the Yavit says that if a person has a choice of learning by Chavrusa in America, in Chutz Laaretz, or learning by yourself in Eretz Yisrael, you should learn by yourself in Eretz Yisrael. He says that it's Machim, Avid Eretz Yisrael, Machim, learn Eretz Yisrael. Part of the problem of learning by yourself is that you're not going to come out with good pshat and good halacha today with a lot of the svarim that we have. That's not such an issue, etc. Now, the Sefer Hasidim says, if you have a really good reason why you don't learn with Chavrusa, there's a lot of noise, there's this, there's that, you can learn by yourself. Prima Gadim says that also about noise. If the noise disturbs you, the Beis Medrash, you learn better on your own, fine. And another thing I saw in Svarim is that this Isser of learning by yourself is talking about Mishnayis and not Gemara. So there are Yesh Eterim. Okay. Now, the way I do it personally, if you want to know personally, I learn beforehand. I learn the whole sugi by myself, and I go over it with my chavrusa to see if I learned it correctly, if he has anything to add, etc., etc. So maybe I'm yotzei that thing, because the issue is not to be metapish, not to learn the sugi wrongly, and so I go. That's why I go over with it. Okay, Zogti Gemara. Omer Rav Nachman. Omer Rav Nachman Yitzchok. Lama nimshul divrei Torah k'eitz? Why is Torah nimshal to what? Shneimar eitz chayim yidam achzikim ba. Loimer loch. Ma eitz kota madlik is a gadol. The small could light up the large. Avtamich hachom k'tanim echadim is a gdoilim. You have the younger guys. They could sharpen up the rabbeim. V'hainu da omer b'chanino. Harbin lamadim rabbeisai. I learned a lot from my own rabbeim. U'mechavei rayosim rabbeisai. There's three levels. I learned the least from my rabbeim. Second to least from my friends. U'metalmidai yosim kulam. Because the talmidim that ask questions invoke a response, and you have to think over the sugya. Sometimes they get you good, is that, and then all of a sudden from Akasha, you get a better clarkai. Rabbi Chanina bar Papa Rami, Siv, Likras, Somei, Hesoyimayim, you, the Rebbe, should go to your Talmidim, Uchsiv, Haikot Somei, Lechulamayim, and then it says that the thirsty, the Talmidim, should come to the Rebbe. Which one is it? You go to the Rebbe comes to you. Im Talmid Hagunu, if he's a great guy, Likras, Somei, Hesoyimayim, like all the guys on Zoom, I go out to them. But if you're not Hagun, Vimloy, I called some Melechula Mayim. You got to come to the Beis Medrash. Boo. I'm saying you guys are not Hagun. That's why you come here.
Well, it's been a rough one. He learned by himself, and he
when he learned by himself, Baba Nuyalu, it was been a rough. Okay. You see that this big hater, Rabbi Yashiv, his entire life learned in what is the name of this shibul over there? Oyel Sarah learned his entire life and became Rabbi Yashiv. He didn't have never in Oyel Sarah. You look over there. What? Special guest from LA. What's your name? Shloimi. I met you there. I did. Shloimi Smiler. Smilo. Shloimi Smiler. Shalom Aleichem. Welcome. Come more often. So, Likras Tzome Yisoyimoyim. Vimloy, huh?
Just said coming here. It's not a shows you. Okay.
No, he's both. He gets it on the Zoom and comes there. It's like, it depends on the day. Chas v'shalom, you should always come. I just said it because we need more room here. But the island that chaps comes here. Vimloy, kol tzome l'chulamayim. Rev Chanina bar Chomer Rami. Siv, yafutzim an yosecha chutza. One guy for sure is not coming again is the chasim. I called him and I'm Aretz. And on this, he's not coming again. Hi! Yefutzman Yisrach Chutza, Ksiv. What's the song Yefutzman Yisrach Chutza? Isn't that a Lubavitch thing? But isn't that the Mashiach told the Baal Shem Tov, Yefutzman Yisrach Chutza? Something like that. Ksiv, Yulichol Avadecho. Hold on. We'll ask, where's Rabbi Adler? I just saw him. Where's Rabbi Adler? No, where's Rabbi Adler?
What song is that?
He's not here today? I thought I saw him this morning. Oh, he is here. Hi. Mazze. Yefutzman Yisrach Chutza. Who said that to who? Mashiach said it to Baal Shem Tov. There you go. Uchsiv. Yad Kislev. Yeah, we're coming up to Yad Kislev. Uchsiv, you lechol levadecho. In Talmud Hagunu, Yefutzman Yisrach Chutza. If you're a private Talmud Chacham, then your Torah goes out. Vim lav. You lechol levadecho. It remains by you. Vomer Mechanino Bar Idi. Lomanim shalu divri Torah lamayim. Why the chsiv? How you call someone lechol lamayim? You're thirsty. Go to the water. How do you achieve Torah? By being humble. Rabbi said being humble. Avdiri Torah. You could, if you want, Aitzis in humility. There's a sefer that came out, sold out already in Amazon. If you're looking for it. Avdiri Torah. Ei miskayim amisha daiti shveila. Torah could only exist by somebody that has humility. Why is Torah compared to these three liquids? In the same pasuk, at the end of the pasuk, uchsiv lechu shivru ve'achaylu lechu shivru b'lo yichesev v'lo mechir yayim v'chalav lo yimalach. Ma'ashloi shemashkem alalu ein miskayim ela v'pachash v'keilim. So two, these three liquids, you put it in kli cheres, it doesn't work well if you put it in expensive keilim. So to Torah, look at this, the Ben Yehuda brings this, he says that yayim chalav and mayim is chayim, life. This is Torah, this is life, that's why it's nimshal. Rabbi Isai says the Gemara, af the Torah is kaim mishadai tishvit. Kida omra le barte the case of the Rishua ben Chananya. Rishua ben Chananya is the Rishua of the entire Shas. When it says Rishua and Shas, it's referring to this. He was a tremendous chacham. He used to fight all of Shas. He fights the Abikarsim, etc. They actually asked him once in some Gemara somewhere. They asked him, what's going to be after you die? Who's going to fight them? And he said, it's from this week's parasha, he said, Nisa v'nelecha v'elcha l'nigdecha. That it's based on the chachma that's in the world. So when the chacham is nifter, then the chachma of the goyim also goes down. So you'll be able to fight them when I'm gone. In Chagiga, that's right. I know where it is. Don't worry about it. You know what daf it is in Chagiga? Hey, I'm with the base. Very good. I pretend I didn't know. What do you think? Zog the Gemara. It says shuffle. You gotta be shuffle. But very good. It is in Chagiga. Says the Gemara. So she said, yeah. Oh, listen to this. Yichachme mefayar bechlim mechayar. Also, Gemara in Chagiga. The Gemara knew, where does it say in Chagiga? That Rabbi Yeshua was Mechayar. In Daf Chav Gimel in Chagiga, it says that he had black teeth. Very black teeth, because he fasted a lot. I guess he wasn't the most pleasant looking person in the world, Rabbi Yeshua. So she tells him, it's a disgusting thing to say. She says, how does all your Torah fit in this ugly body of yours? He wasn't a spal at all. Omar lo, Ovich Romin Chamra B'mani de Pachra. How does your father, stop, he changes the subject. He's trying to enter, but she wasn't a grace of Alice Kishrin. She didn't have what he's saying. He said to her, where does your father place the wine? In earthenware. Amalei, near me. So what do you want him to put? You're very chashiv. You're king, whatever you are. Rabbi wanted to have a chaspa. Shouldn't you put it in golden and silver vessels? So she said over what she heard. Rami lecham Rabbi wanted to have a chaspa. So they took the wine, they put it into gold and silver. Utakif. Yeah, I told you the story 1,000 times. Say it again for the new guys. I had a Hagolah Kalim business. And this Assyrian woman came with like 6 golden bechers, gold. But they say it doesn't taste very good. That's why today they put like a little plating in there. It just shouldn't ruin the wine. So it got ruined. Who told you, who gave you this crazy idea to put wine in gold? They called him. Why did you tell us to do that? She told me that Torah doesn't fit in ugly, so I said, what about wine? I wanted to show you wine. If you want to keep wine, you put it in ugly. You don't put it in gold. Torah also only stays. Before we turn the page, I just want to point out a very interesting tesis on the bottom. It's nothing to do with what we're talking about now. But he says, like 5 lines from the bottom, he says that Shmuel was an astrologer. He learned it all in the bathroom. As I said, tesis, pointing it out. I saw it here. I wanted to point it out to you. I'm not doing a bit of Torah learning astrology. It's when I'm in the bathroom, that's when I learn it. Okay. What?
Can you repeat that again for the women who are listening to your share right now?
No. Zainab Bays, sponsored by Adam Vales, in memory of my mother, Gilev Rathner. Abigail Pesach V'chava Rivka. But there's another one I forgot to print out. What is it? Oh, for Shiduchim, for?
Siblings in himself.
Zchus Shiduch for siblings in himself. Amen. You have, but there's good-looking people that are Tamil Chachamim. You have a sonu. If they were not that good-looking, Tfei have a gmiri according to Rashi. Says Rashi, because people that are good looking, it's very hard for them to be humble, and as we said, humility and Torah go together. Rashi says the word clear over here. Since they're clear, they're not very thick. So if something falls into wine, it'll fall to the bottom, ruin it, you'll be disgusted by it. Whereas, let's say you have honey, oil, something falls to the top, you just pull it off the top. Torah also, you have to constantly chazer over Torah, you can't forget about Torah. The day of rain. Once a year, when that first rain falls, it's like the day that the heaven and earth were created. Shenemar, harifu shomayim imal. There should be a shower in the upper heavens. Rishchokim yizlu tzedek. Come down. Eretz. Tiftach eretz. V'yifru yesha utzdoka tatzmiach yachad. Ani Hashem berosim. Singular. Says Gemara berosim lo nemar. We're starting off eretz shomayim v'aretz. That's two. And instead of saying brasim, I created those two, it's talking about the one. Which one? The rain. In other words, rain, the one rain, is more important than Shemayim Varis HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Omar Rabbi Yishaya Godol Yoyim HaGshomim Shafilu Yeshua Parav Ravaboy. Interesting. Rashi says, the Malachim go in and ask for Yeshua for us. It's amazing, Rashi. You should see it inside. Shenema Tiftach Eretz V'Yifru Yesha. The Malachim. There's a time the Malachim go in. When? When there's a bracha on this world, you find the day of bracha. When's the bracha? When the Geshem. So they say, oh, there's bracha. Let's go in to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ask for Klal Yisrael for Yeshua. Omer Rabbi Tanachum Bar Chenilai. So Rabbi Isai, we're going to go through. Here I actually made a list. I think I printed it. Maybe not. Wasn't worthy. Oh, it was. Okay. These are the things that could prevent rain. If Klai Sol doesn't have a mechila, there's no kapara. If Klai Sol is chayiv misa, if Klai Sol doesn't bring trumas and maestris, if Klai Sol speaks lashon hara, these are all things that are going to stop the rain. And rain equals we don't know, we don't care anymore, we're not farmers. Rain, we get produce, who cares? No, it's our sustenance. Without it, we don't live. If Klai Sol is azeponim, bitul toira, gezel. These are all the things we're going to see one after another here. Agadata. Or if Tanakh Bachaniloi, Enakshom Yardim Elohim Kane, Nimchal Abani Sam Shisrol, you need a kapara. Shinemar Rotiso, Hashem Artzecha, Shafto Shivus Yaakov, Nasasa Avenamecha. You forgave Klai Yisrael, Kisisa Kochachosam Selah. All is Ziri Midiyahavis. Now, was it Ziri before? Maybe I made a mistake. Zera. Sorry. So this is Ziri. Rashi points out he's Midiyahavis, he's not the typical Ziri, he's at the end. So, he's before then. The Ziri that we have typically is all the way at the end of when they wrote the Gemara. He's not. He's the Yahavis. L'ravina. Atu ma'alchem asnizlo. I know ma'alchem asnizlo. I learned from a different pasuk. V'ato tishma shumayim v'solachto l'chatas. Here, and it says all the way at the end of the pasuk. Here, solachto. And then it says, v'nosata matar al artzecha. If there's a slicha, there's matar. Or Rebbe Tachon v'reidu r'chi, another pshat. Ish kfar akot. Einak shom netzarim. It only stops. Elim kein ischai v'sanem sh'yisrael. In other words, again, Alash and Saginah, we're talking about Klai Yisrael themselves. Kloya, if they deserve to be destroyed, then there's no rain. Shenemar, Tzio, Gamchoim, Tzio is a Lashon of dry. Yigzalu, Meimei Sheleg, Sheol Chatu. Omele Ziri, Midi Havaz, the Ravina, Atum, Ochem, Asnilalo, Anom, Ochem, Asnilalo, we learn from here. Votzar, Sashamayim, Vavatam, Meira. Okay, you'll be, if Vavatam, Meira means, Ashkosh Boch will destroy Klai Yisrael. And before that is Va'atar Shemaim, there's not going to be rain. They go hand in hand. If we're Chayiv Misa, then there won't be Va'atar Shemaim. Omer Rav Chisda, Enek Shem Netzar Melech Shul Bittul Trumas and Maestros. We know, we're not going to go through it again, but why not? There's a chart. If you have produce, this is what you have to bring. To bring a little Truma, a little Maeser, a little Trumas Maeser. My son already knows about Peh. I see him telling his friend over there. Yeah. Why? Because we have the chart. We talk about it. So, if you don't give these Trumas and Maestros, the 2%, the 10%, then there won't be any rain. Shinemar, Tzio, Gamchoim, Yigzlu, Meme, Sheleg, my Mashma. How do you see Trumas and Maestros in this puzzle? Tanavei, Yishmol, Bishvil, Dvorim, Shetzivisi. So the Gemara is taking the word Tzio and changing it into Tziva. What I commanded you, be Maisachama, what did I command you to do in the summer? Well, I see some you didn't do, which is Trumas and Maestros. Yigzlu, Mekem, Meme, Sheleg, be Maisachom. Or Rishim, and Pazi. Hey, Inak, Shom, Net, Sorim, El, Shvil, Misapri, Lashonara. The reason there's no rain is because people talk Lashonara. Shinemar. Ruach Tzofoin, the Choyel Geshem, upon him, Nizomim, Lashin says, I saw a tremendous Kidrug and Klai Yisrael in the workplace. I used to see with my employees. Goyim are makbid on Lashon Hara. A lot of them. The proper ones. Gershon, you put it a little lower, please. Thank you. Every 2 minutes, it's like the air conditioner with him. Once he's in controls. Yeah, so I'm saying it's a kitrug. They have this concept of gossip, no gossip. It's a kitrug for me, yes. That was it. Omer Rav Sola, Omer Rav Amnuno, Hinak Shon Nesar, Shkoyach, 2 days in a row. Put me like Mamash Revaish me, Rabim. Luschus, Akiva Simcha, Ben Fega. Omer Rav Amnuno, Hinak Shon Nesar, Vishvil, Aziponim. There's a concept called Aziponim. Where are the Aziponim around there? People, Mchutzafim. Shenema Vim, no, Revivim, Malkish Loyoya. What's Aziponim? It's Mchutzaf to Gdoilim, to Samil Chachamim. Aziponim. Those guys prevent Klai Yisrael from rain. There's not going to be rain. What's the end of the pasuk? This is important. Mayanti calling. You refused to be embarrassed. That's Azponim. Omer Rav Sola. Omer Rav Nuno kolom sheshli Azponim. If you have Azponim, soif nichshel ba'aveir. At the end, you're going to sin. Shenemar umeitzachish zoyin ha'yolach. And then the pasuk. Mayanti calling. Rav Nachman Omer. Biyadua shenichshel ba'aveir. It's not it's going to happen. You should know already happened. Shenemar, hoya loch. It happened in the past already. He's already nishal. But shenemar, yeloch. Don't say it's going to happen. Hoya. Omer Rav Ravuna, kolam sheshli has his ponim. Listen to this Gemara. Unbelievable. Don't take it literally. I don't want Doilam going out there and calling you. Your has ponim. Poof, poof, poof. Mutu lekroisi rasha. We have a chiyuv, says Rashi. V'ahavta l'reacha kamaychoy. A mitzvah d'oraisa to love a fellow Jew. If a person is a has ponim, you see a guy getting up, making fun of a Rav, and this and that, he's as upon him, you're permitted to call him a Rasha. You don't have the mitzvah after the Recha Kamaychus. Shenemar, Ha'ez ish Rasha b'fonov, says Toisvis, Av agav d'arminim b'kiddushin ha'koy l'chaveri Rasha yoridim l'chayov. It's awesome to call your friend the Rasha. L'zeh mutter, you're allowed to. D'vadi nichshal b'averi v'oim b'mirdoi, he's rebelling against HaKadosh Baruch Hu. D'akor as ponov onzabah, you could see it on his face, you could see that type of guy. Now, people are going to take it literally. There's a Gemara that says that you're allowed to, actually, it's a Tosis, I think, we learned once. You're allowed to burn a third of his belongings, such a guy. Again, don't go around burning people. Ask the Rav first. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak Omar. Mutilis Noisai, you're allowed to hate him. Over here, this is where Rashi says, you're allowed to hate him. Shenema Va'oiz Panav Yishuna, Atikri Yishuna, which means to transform. Ela Yisonei. It's with a shin, we change it to a sin. Yisonei, you can hate him. People that don't learn Torah. And that could apply to anybody. It doesn't mean the guy in Koil making a lot of coffees. It means people in the workforce who spend way too much time on their phones, on their devices, and instead of learning Torah, that's Bittul Torah. Because of laziness, the roof falls in. That's what happened to me, or it's going to happen to me. Being lazy, not calling up the guy to fix the roof. Then you have roof issues. Because they were lazy, they were on the couch watching stuff. They become the enemy of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, becomes poor. It causes problems with parnasah. Roofs the upper heavens with water. Boyer who bashchakim is going to be patchy skies. In other words, it's about to rain. But the wind comes and takes away those patches that we need for the rain to fall. Vein or el toira. Oh, Raboisai, listen to this. Not himself to himself. It's geschmack to do the daf is what we say. Should have been in the beginning of the song. To never miss a day. Are you going to sing? Vada. Oh. Veinor el Torah. By the way, I think the pshat in the pasuk is a new pshat. I don't know, a new pshat. Maybe it's an old pshat. You'll find it. Rabbi Tzvi Adler is going to send it to me later. Kiner mitzvah, ner, is a very... Ner is a very... Gary, I don't want to talk Lashon Hara about you, but... Ner is a very small candle, and Or is very large. Ner mitzvah. Make it lower, Gary, please. I know it's late, but I got the hint. Hey, nor elatari. He came in one of these moves today. Shem Yirachem. Hey, nor elatari. Shenemar ki ner mitzvah betoira or. Fine. Rabbi Sai, have a wonderful day. Motzi Shabbos, 7:30. We'll start off from here. You have a valid day.